Welcome, dear students, to lecture 3 of module 4. In this lecture, we learn about Chinese remainder theorem. Let us learn about Chinese remainder theorem. One of the most useful results of number theory is the Chinese remainder theorem. In essence, the Chinese remainder theorem says it is possible to reconstruct integers in a certain range from their residues modulo a set of pairwise relatively prime moduli. So let us learn about the theorem. Now if you can let M1, M2 and MR be a collection of pairwise relatively prime numbers, integers. Then the system of simultaneous congruences X is congruent to A1 mod M1, X is congruent to A2 mod M2, so X is congruent to AR mod MR, has a unique solution modulo M which is equal to M1 into M2. M1 to M2 into MR for any given integers A1, A2 to AR. So how is this? Now we have to put capital M is equal to M1 into M2 to whatever number of prime numbers you have, multiple product of that. And for each K is equal to 1, 2 to R, let MK is equal to capital M by the prime numbers. Then GCD of MK and MK, that is they are relatively prime to each other, will be equal to 1 for all K. Let yk be an inverse of mk modulo small mk for each k. Then by definition of inverse, we have mk yk is congruent to 1 mod of mk. How do we find x? So x will be equal to a1 m1 y1 plus a2 m2 y2 till whatever amount of a1s and m1s you have plus ar mr yr. Then x is a simultaneous solution to all of the congruences. Since the moduli M1 to MR are pairwise relatively prime, any two simultaneous solutions to the systems must be congruent modulo M. Thus, the solution is a unique congruence class modulo M and the value of X computed above is in that class. So, we'll work out numericals based on Chinese remainder theorem. Then, you'll be able to understand exactly what the Chinese remainder theorem is. Let us solve a numerical on Chinese remainder theorem. So here, three equations are given here. We have to find x where x is congruent to 2 mod 3, x is congruent to 3 mod 5 and x is congruent to 2 mod 7. Now we have to find a value of x. So what we'll do is, first we'll list out whatever is given over here. So first I will write a1. So a1 is got from the first equation, that is 2. A2 from the second, that is 3, and A3 which is equal to again 2. Next we will list out M1. Small M1 is from equation 1 is 3, small M2 from 2 is 5 and small M3 is 7. Now we will calculate capital M. So capital M is equal to M1 into M2 into M3 which is equal to 3 into 5 into 7. So we get this as 105. Now from this we have to calculate capital M1. So capital M1 is capital M by small m1, that is 105 divided by 3. So we get this as 35. Next, M2. M2 is again capital M by small M2. So 105 divided by 5, which is equal to 21. Then M3 is equal to capital M by small M3. Is equal to 105 divided by 7. So we get this as equal to 50. So now we are done finding out what is capital M1, M2 and M3. Next step is we have to find the Y1. Now Y1 here is inverse, multiplicative inverse, because capital M1 and small m1 are relatively prime to each other, therefore we'll have a multiplicative inverse. So capital m1 y1 is congruent to 1 mod small m1. So we'll substitute the values over here. Capital M1 is 35. Y1 is a multiplicate inverse which we need to find. 1 mod M1 is 3. So now a simpler way of finding the here before we find the multiplicate inverse, this 35, we can first we have to do mod M1, that is mod 3, because it is more than greater than 3. So 35 mod 3, we get it as 2y1 congruent to 1 mod 3. So now we can use this particular formula 3a, that is this 3 mod whatever m we have 3, and another some variable a I will take, plus the remainder here is 1, so that here divided by this capital M1, that I'll take in the denominator to find the value. Now we have to substitute different values of a and see that we get a whole number as the answer over here. Now when I substitute a is equal to 1 only, I'll get the answer as 2. So capital 1 for a is equal to 1, I get the answer as 2. So cap the multiplicate inverse y1 is equal to 2. You substitute over here, 2 into 2 will be 4, 4 mod 3 will be 1. So we get the answer as 1. That is why this is the multiplicate inverse. Okay, this is y1. Next we need to find y2. So finding y2, again we take m2, y2 is congruent to 1 mod m2. So what is capital m2? It is 21. y2 congruent to 1 mod that m2 is 5 over here. So again, see, 21 is greater than 5, so we'll do 21 mod 5. So 21 mod 5 will give us 1 y2, right? So 20, 5 4 is 20, so what is the remainder? 1. So we get 1 y2 is congruent to 1 mod 5. So here I can write this as, now let us take the same way as we have taken the formula over here. It is 5a plus the remainder is 1 divided by again 1 over here. So here if I substitute a is equal to 1, we get 5 into 1 plus 1. So I get the answer as 6. Therefore, y2 is equal to 6. See, if I substitute over here, 1 into 6 is 6, 6. 6 mod 5 is 1. We will calculate y3 now. So m3 y3 is congruent to 1 mod m3. So 15y3 is congruent to 1 mod 7. Again, 15 is greater than 7, so when you divide, 7 2s are 14, so remainder is 1. So you get this also as 1y3 is congruent to 1 mod 7. So here we write it as 7a plus 1 divided by 1. So if I substitute a is equal to 1, I get this as 8. Therefore, y3 will be 8. Now substituting for x. So formula to find x is small a1 capital M1 y1 plus small a2 capital M2 y2 plus a3 m3 plus y3 into mod of capital M. So let us substitute all the values. We have already calculated some values and some are given. So here 2 into 35 into y1 we got as 2 plus 3 into m2 is 21, y2 is 6 plus a3, that is again 2 into 15 into 8 mod of capital M is 105. So we get the answer as here 758 mod 105. So finally, taking the modulus, we get this as 23 mod 105. So now what you do is you substitute this 23 over here in the equation. So what we had the equation as, so initially we had the equation as, this given equation was x is congruent to 2 mod 3. Now, if I put x in the place of x, if I put 23, now 23 mod 3. 23 mod 3 is what? 7 3s are 21. Then 21, but we have 23, right? So, what is the remainder? 2. So, I get this answer as 2. Next, again, next is again, x is congruent to 3 mod 5. Now, x is 23, we know. 23 mod 5 was 5 was a 20. So, what is the remainder? 3. So, this is also satisfied. Next given condition or equation is 2 mod 7. Okay. So, here 23 mod 7. So again, 7 3s are 21. So, what is the remainder? 2. So, all the three conditions are satisfied for x equal to 23. So, this is how work out a problem using Chinese remainder theorem. So, let us consider another example. So, in this question here, we have x is congruent to 3 mod 6, x is congruent to 6 mod 7, and x is congruent to 10 mod 11. We need to find the value of x. So, first let us list out whatever is given. So, a1 is given, it is equal to 3, a2 is given as 6, and a3 is given as 10. Next, small m1 is 6, m2 is 7. And m3 is equal to 11. Let us find capital M. So, capital M is 6 into 7 into 11, which we get as 462. Now, let us calculate capital M1, which is equal to M by M1. So, here it is 462 divided by 6, which we get equal to 77. Then M2 is equal to capital M by small m2. It is again 462 divided by 7. So, we get this as 66. M3 is equal to 400, that is M3 by A3, that is 462, sorry, M3 by capital M by small m3, so 462 by 11, which will give us 42. Now we need to find the values of y1. So m1 y1 is congruent to 1 mod m1. So capital M1 we have got as 77. Y1 we need to calculate. This is 1 because capital m1 and small m1 are relatively prime, therefore we have the GCD as 1. So, we have a multiplicative inverse which is equal to y1, 1 mod 6. Again, see 77 is greater than 6. So, we have to first do mod 77 mod 6. So, when you do 77 mod 6, we get the answer as 5y1 is 5 as a remainder. So, 5y1 is congruent to 1 mod 6. So, this to calculate y1, I'll write 6a plus 1 divided by 5. So, here A is equal to 1 if I take and substitute the values. I need to find what values we get for. So on, we have to go on substitute until you get a whole number. So A equal to 1, A equal to 2, A equal to 3, we will not get a whole number. But for A equal to 4, I will get the answer as 5. Therefore, Y1 is equal to 5. Coming to the next one, again M2 Y2 is congruent to 1 mod M2. So, capital M2 is 66 Y2 is congruent to 1 mod 7. So, 66 is again greater than 7. So, first we will reduce it, or we will do 66 mod 7. So, we get as 3 Y2 is congruent to 1 mod 7. So, to calculate again Y2, here 7A plus 1 by 3 let us take. So, when I substitute for A values, if when I substitute A is equal to 2, I get the answer as 5. Therefore, Y2 is equal to 5. Next, the Y3 you have to find. So, capital M3 is 42. Y3 is congruent to 1 mod small m3, that is 11. So, here 42 is greater than 11. So, first we will do 42 mod 11, which will yield us the answer 9. So, 9 y3 is congruent to 1 mod 11. So here we can write it as 11a plus 1 divided by 9. So when I do the substitution, for a is equal to 4, we get this as 5. Therefore, y3 is equal to 5. Now substituting in the given formula, you know the formula already. We have in the previous numerical we have seen that. So here let us just substitute. So here it is a3. Okay, sorry, a1. So a1 we know it as 3 into this is m1 is 77 into y1 5 plus a2 is 6 plus capital M2, sorry, into this is capital M2 is 66 into 5, that is Y2 plus it is 10 is A3 into 42 is M2 into 5, whole of this into mod of capital M, that is mod 462. So when you multiply, we get this as 5235 mod 462. So when I do modulus, we get the final answer as 153 mod 462. So x answer, so x is equal to 153. You substitute in those three same equations, you should be getting the remainder as mentioned there. So let us see one more numerical. So in this given numerical, we have to find x for x is congruent to 1 mod 25, x is congruent to 17 mod 26 and x is congruent to 11 mod 27. So first let us list out all the given values there. So a1 is equal to 1, a2 is equal to 17 and a3 is equal to 11 and small m1 is equal to 25, small m2 is equal to 26 and m3 is equal to 27. Let us find the capital M, which is a which we have to multiply m1, m2 and m3, that is 25 into 26 into 27, which will give us an answer of 17550. Now we have to find capital M1, which is equal to 17550 divided by 25. We'll get it as 702. Capital M2 is equal to 17550 divided by 26, which is equal to 675. Capital M3 is equal to 17550 divided by 27 is equal to 650. Now let us calculate Y1. So M1 Y1 is congruent to 1 mod M, small m1. So here capital M1 we have got it as 702. So Y1 is congruent to 1 mod 25. Now again see here, 702 is greater than 25. So first we will do 702 mod 25. So when we do that, we get it as 2y1 congruent to 1 mod 25. So let me write this as 25a plus 1 divided by 2. So for a is equal to 1, I get this as 13. Therefore, y1 is equal to 13. Next, we need to find y2. So, m2 y2 is congruent to 1 mod m2. This is m2 is 675, y2 congruent to 1 mod m2, that is 26. So here we write it as 26a plus 1 divided by, sorry, 675 first we will reduce. So we'll do 675 mod 26. So we get this as 25y2 is congruent to 1 mod 6. So this is divided by 25 again. So when you substitute all the values of A, when A is equal to 24, we get this as 25. Therefore, Y2 will be equal to 25. We need to substitute all the values from A equal to 1, A equal to 2, A equal to 3, so on. We have to go on substituting till A is equal to 24 only. Then we are going to get a whole number here. So the Y2 will be 25. Next, now we have to calculate Y3. So Y3 will be here. 650 Y3 is congruent to 1 mod 27. Again, 650 is greater than 27. So 650 mod 27 we are going to get as 2. So 2Y3 is congruent to 1 mod 27. So here 27A plus 1 divided by 2. So when A is equal to 1, we get this as 14. Therefore, Y3 will be equal to 14. Now we have to substitute. So X equal to, so A1 is 1 into M1 is 702 into Y1 is 13 plus A2 is equal to 17 into Y2 is M2 is equal to 675 into Y2 is equal to 25. Plus A3 is 11 into M3 is 650 into Y3 is equal to 14 mod of 17550, which will give me 396101 mod 17550. So we get X equal to 1001. So this is the answer. So if you substitute this as X, we have to get the remainders as 1, 17 and 11. So this is all about Chinese remainder theorem. Thank you.